In this video, we're going to look at Web3 versus Web2. You're probably aware that there's a huge upgrade going on right now in the technological advancement of the internet. So I'm going to inform you everything that you need to know in order to stay up to date.
Nothing I say on this channel is financial advice. Always do your own research before investing any money.
Let's get into today's video. So what does Web2 mean, and what is Web3, and how is it different? Well, Web1 was basically the original internet, where you could go online and maybe you could read a bit of information about different things, different articles, newspapers, etc. So pretty much you had no interaction with the internet. All you were doing was using it to find out information. Web2 was when you then got upgraded and you were allowed to do things using things like Google services, where you could search online, you could go to Amazon, you could shop online, and you could do various other bits and pieces. You could then go and create your own websites through centralized servers, such as Amazon Web Service, Google Cloud servers, and much, much more. But notice how in the picture, that's all centralized. So everything is going towards these central systems, which is okay. But one problem with that is it gives those companies a monopoly, and they are paid around $3.9 trillion every single year, which is a huge amount of money. The move from Web2 to Web3 is a huge evolution in the internet. Now, effectively, you're going to move away from that centralization through various servers, and it's going to be built directly onto the internet through companies like ICP or Internet Computer, built by Definity, which is a very, very cool project indeed. And this means that instead of centralizing servers and everything running to those centralized servers, those servers are then spread out and distributed, and each computer around the world is basically providing bandwidth. Therefore, you're going to be able to gain rewards for doing such things, which is also very cool, and you're going to be able to contribute to the network in ways you've never seen before. This is also a very exciting thing because you're going to be able to do things using trustless systems. Now, that might sound a bit weird, but what I mean is, instead of traditional banking, where if I wanted to send you money, I would have to do it via my bank to your bank, and ultimately you would get hold of it. Now, this can work in a trustless system through things like cryptocurrency, where I can directly send a transaction to you. You will then receive that, and no one in the middle had anything to do with it. This is great because it's much cheaper. It's also transparent, but it's also complete freedom given to the individual and takes power away from the larger corporations all around the world and redistributes it between individuals. Now, diving into Investopedia's definition of what Web2 really is basically describing the current state of the internet. Web2 was the 21st century version of the internet, with Web1 arising within the 1990s. If you think about the rulers of Web2, well, you've got your Facebooks, your Instagrams, Googles, Amazon, etc. And these have all been very interesting and cool platforms. But all the content on that platform belongs to the platform. So for example, I'm making a video on YouTube right now. This is Web2. That means that if YouTube so wants to do so, they can remove my content from the internet and there's nothing I can do about it. I don't really have full ownership of my channel. Ultimately, my channel belongs to YouTube and not myself. However, once we shift into Web3, that's going to be completely different. I will then have access, potentially, I'll have access to my own platforms. They'll all be completely individually managed, and it means I have full ownership of my own creations. So from here, we can kind of start to build a picture of what Web3 is, but Web3 is such a new concept that many people can't really define exactly what it is. But in my opinion, Web3 is pretty much full ownership to the individual. That's ownership of your content, that's ownership of your data through massive AI data clouds that are collecting huge amounts of data all the time about you normally. So when you're online using Facebook, etc., you're probably getting hit up with ads for Amazon and ads for various things you didn't realize that you even needed, and that's because there is programs already gaining data on you. The data is then sold on, and the profits from that data is taken by people like Google and Amazon. However, in the future, with Web3 and coins like Jasmine, which if you've been in crypto for a while have probably heard of, you will have access to being able to provide your data to other people in return for money in the form of Jasmine tokens. So not only does it give you full ownership, but you can then decide whether or not you want to share data with other people, what level of data you want to share, and much, much more. Right now, we don't really have a choice in that. Every time we're using the internet, we are being exploited for our data. Now, I've already talked about the major difference in currency, and it's cryptocurrency that's basically allowed the Web3 environment to flourish. Traditionally, you had fiat currencies such as the euro, the US dollar, the GBP, and whatever, and these meant that governments had ultimate control over the people using those currencies. The banks effectively decided on the price of different things and were able to control inflation interest rates, whereas now we have cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, which is inflation proof because there's only ever going to be a certain amount of Bitcoin produced. produced. So this is great because it doesn't give any government centralized control over any currency, and as an individual, you're then responsible for your currency. I've already talked about the pros of being able to trade directly from peer to peer, so from person to person rather than through a centralized organization. Now, I've already talked about the centralization of content creation, such as Instagram, YouTube, etc. However, Internet Computer, or ICP, has been building a third generation internet directly onto the internet rather than through centralized cloud services. And on this platform alone, you're seeing tons of new decentralized apps popping up. You've got OpenChat, which is basically like WhatsApp. You have various other platforms here like DSCVR, which is the alternative to Reddit. We've got various other gaming platforms, NFT marketplaces, everything that you can think of that can operate autonomously without the input from anyone else. This is essentially very cool because no one is then going to be able to control you or manipulate your data in the future, and it gives everyone freedom to create content whenever they want without and providing them full ownership of their own content. Now, something else that Internet Computer boasts is it's built directly onto the internet. Therefore, it is limited only by web speed, unlike everything else in Web 2, which is limited by the servers that are running the internet. This might sound a bit confusing, and don't worry, it's confusing me as well, but I just understand that the speed from Web 3 will be way beyond that of Web 2 without the limitations you've probably experienced before. Another great thing about the Internet Computer. Previously, you probably heard of different types of coding languages such as Java, C++, and these different coding languages were not interoperable. So what that meant is one different platform that uses certain types of code wouldn't be able to read code from another website. Therefore, lacking interoperability, it meant that apps, etc., couldn't be used across different networks. But the Internet Computer brings all of these different things together and provides a coding language that combines different coding languages in order to make it easier for people to create all sorts of different content and in order for the community to work together to build the future of the internet. Now, that might all sound extremely confusing, and it is quite complicated, and I myself am not particularly tech savvy, but I've looked into it and it's definitely worth a read. I recommend going and checking out internetcomputer.org, link down below in the description if you want to find out more about this incredible platform. There's also other cryptos such as Quant that are helping bridge the gap between different blockchains. Blockchain is basically the backbone of Web3, and Web3 is built onto the blockchain. One thing is for sure though, guys, Web3 will change the way that you enjoy the internet, and it's going to provide you with a much faster, more enjoyable, and more profitable experience of browsing the internet. I hope you enjoyed today's video, guys. If you did, hit that thumbs up for me. If you want to know more about Web3, you want to know more about crypto, NFTs, and much, much more, then hit subscribe, and I will see you in the very next episode. Bye-bye.